Good morning, sir. I'm Jernie Stoya. This video presentation is about the whole topic of week 13 to 17. Topic 13, important features of Asia. Asia is the largest of the world continents, covering approximately 30% of the Earth's land area. It is also the world's most populous continent, with roughly 60% of the total population. Asia makes up the eastern portion of Eurasia supercontinent. Europe occupies the western portion. The borders between the two continents is debated. However, most geographers define Asia's western border as an indirect line that follows the Ural Mountains, the Caucasus Mountains, and the Caspian and Black Seas. Asia is bordered by the Arctic, Pacific, and Indian Oceans. Asia's physical geography, environment and resources, and human geography can be considered separately. Asia can be divided into five physical regions: mountain, plateaus, plains, steppes, and deserts, freshwater environments, and saltwater environments. Week 14, the importance of Europe. Europe is the second smallest continent. Only Oceania has less landmass. Europe extend from the island nation of Iceland in the west to the Ural Mountains of Russia in the east. Europe's northernmost point is the Svalbard archipelago of Norway, and it reaches as far south as the islands of Greece and Malta. Europe is sometimes described a peninsula of peninsulas. A peninsula is a piece of land surrounded by water on three sides. Europe is a peninsula of the Eurasian supercontinent, and is bordered by the Arctic Ocean to the north, the Atlantic Ocean to the west, and the Mediterranean, Black, and Caspian Sea to the south. Europe's main peninsula are the Iberian, Italian, and Balkan, located in the southern Europe. In the Scandinavian and Jutland, located in the northern Europe. The link between these peninsulas has made Europe a dominant economic, social, and cultural force throughout recorded history. Week 15, the importance of Africa. The second largest continent is bounded by the Mediterranean Sea, the Red Sea, the Indian Ocean, and the Atlantic Ocean. It is divided in the half almost equally by the equator. Africa's physical geography, environment, and resources, and human geography can be considered separately. Africa has an array of diverse ecosystems, from sandy deserts to lush rainforests. Africa has 8 major physical regions: the Sahara, the Sahel, the Ethiopian Highlands, the Savannah, the Swahili Coast, the Rainforest, the African Great Lakes, and Southern Africa. Some of these regions cover large bands of continents, such as the Sahara and Sahel, while others are isolated areas such as the Ethiopian Island and the Great Lakes. Each of these regions has unique animal and plant community. Week 16, the importance of America. The continent of United States may be divided into 7 broad physiographic divisions. From east to west, the Atlantic Gulf coastal plain, Appalachian Highlands, the Interior Plains, the Interior Highlands, the Rocky Mountain System, the Intermountain Region, and Pacific Mountain System. An 8th Division, the Laurentian Uplands, as part of Canadian Shield, dips into the United States from Canada. In the Great Lakes region, it is an area of little local relief, with an irregular drainage system and many lakes, as well as some of the oldest exposed rocks in the United States. The terrain of United States was formed by the Great Continental Ice Sheets that covered North America during the late Cenozoic era. The southern edge of the ice sheets is broadly traced by a line of terminal moraines extending west from East Long Island and then along the course of Ohio and Missouri rivers to the Rocky Mountains. Land north of this line is covered by glacial material. Alaska and the mountain of Northwest United States had extensive mountain glaciers and were heavily eroded. Large glacial lakes occupied sections of the basin and range province. The Great Salt Lake and the other lakes of this region are remnants of the glacial lake. Week 17, the important features of Australia. Oceania is a region made up of thousands of islands throughout the Central and South Pacific Oceans. It includes Australia, the smallest continent in terms of total land area. Most Australia and Oceania is under the Pacific, a vast body of water that is larger than all the Earth's continental land masses and island combined. The name of Oceania justly established the Pacific Ocean as the defining characteristic of the continent. Oceania is dominated by the nation of Australia. The other two major land masses of Oceania are the microcontinent of Zealandia, which includes the country of New Zealand, and the eastern half of the island of New Guinea. Made up of the nation of Papua New Guinea, Oceania also includes three island regions: Melanesia, Micronesia, and Polynesia. Oceania's physical geography, environment and resources, and human geography can be considered separately. Oceania can be divided into three island groups: Continental Island, High Island, and Low Island. The islands in each groups are formed in different ways and are made up of different materials. Continental Island have a variety of physical features, while High and Low Islands are fairly uniform in their physical geography.